Hi, some good thing that I have come across and I just wanted to tell you all. कुछ खास बातें जो आप तक पहुंचाना चाहता था वो ये थी कि ऐसी 12 चीजें हैं जो मेरी निगाह में थी और बहुत दिन से सोच रहा था, तो I thought let me come and just let you also know. I mean you would also need some kind of a reinforcement, right? And here I am. First thing is, don't just learn. Experience. I'm talking to everybody. People say that life is learning. I mean, you should be open to learning, open to lifelong learning. What is learning? Learning is nothing but an experience. I am very, very sure that experience is something which is there, you know, deep engraved in your mind. Experience is something that you can narrate. Experience is something that you can give other as a moral, you know, and make them ready for their. Maybe if they come across, it becomes a life lesson for them as well. So I think learn, but rather have experience out of it, right? Good or bad, anything. Don't just read, absorb. I have a lot of students, you know, I keep talking to a lot of students. Maybe for past 6 months, more than 15,000 students that I must have reached out through my online training. And I clearly see, you know, a huge gap of reading. Research clearly shows that not many have a great love for reading. And that's the reason many a times, you know, comprehension or interpretation or analysis and responses are altered. So when you read, just do not read for the heck of it. Let's try and maybe read less. As if we are not reading, you know, great. But whenever you are reading, try to absorb what is the idea, the thought behind, the thread woven of the entire passage or entire, you know, read. So that is something which I personally feel. Third, don't just change, transform. If you are, let's say, myself for that matter, I have been always a subdued, reserved kind of a person, and now I am up there on this platform, talking to you all, interacting and trying to interact more is a transformation, a big transformation from a guy, from a boy who was a backbencher, who was always shy, who thought that he would never speak, would never come and show up as a cricketer, who's never come up as a musician, would never come up as a master of ceremony or an anchor and do something called as news reading as I'm doing now. Never thought. So transformation is there for all. It is not only me. You just need to, you know, kind of be conscious. A conscious lot who knows what kind of a personality he or she is only needs that kind of a push, and it should be inside out. Transformation is for your better tomorrow. Whatever that you are today, let's try and be a better tomorrow, right? And I always believe this strongly, that if you are trying to do something new, if you have picked up something new, and if you really, you know, doing it, if you are into it with great conviction, transformation will definitely happen. The third thing that reminds me, don't just promise, prove. Holocosmicity is a great concept. We do not care, but we ask often, how are you? Do not make promise that I'll come back. If you genuinely mean, go and visit someone. If you promise someone to deliver something, maybe a book, maybe in kind, if maybe anything that is all material, but still people need it, right? Maybe a just plain visit. If promises are met, I think you'll never regret in your life. You'll never have that kind of a guilt that you haven't done something for a person whom you have loved, whom you have cared. So that's something you should do it. If you have promised, deliver it, prove it. Right. The next thing that comes to my mind is a fifth thing, that don't just criticize. There are so many critics among us. The one good thing that they would see, for example, people are online, people are doing so many things. People are singing, people are dancing, people are out there, you know, teaching how to become a trainer, a motivational speaker, suddenly, you know, are Vedic maths. There are a lot of things happening online, and it has suddenly caught up, unaware. This domino effect has caught everyone. Everyone wants to be there on this platform, showcased. Don't criticize. If you're not them, you cannot be better than them, right? So at least if you want to be, if not better, as good as them, encourage. One good word and encouragement, a word of encouragement will take them miles ahead. Just be that support. Even if you do not like them as a personality, appreciate what kind of a work they are doing. I explained to you transformation. Transformation would also begin when you start appreciating people. The next thing that reminds me is the sixth point. Don't just think. Ponder. Think. You think a lot of things, right? We have a lot of thinking going on. When you are alone, saddest, baddest, hardest, and the most worst thing that we can think. All in mind. Never speak out. So it's only there. You only know when you are alone what you're thinking. You act what you think. That is the gap which you need to ponder about. What is that act which is actually getting influenced by what you think is controlling you? If that is controlling you, you are an attitude. And if that attitude is being easily watched, being noticed by others, not good, right? So if you're thinking, I think you need to mind your thinking, control your thinking, and ponder about it. How advantageous, how beneficial, how constructive it is going to go with you and the society at large. The next thing that reminds me is the seventh point. Don't just take. Always a taker. Also be a giver. If you do not have enough money, you would have your own self to contribute to anyone. Maybe give them time. Time is the most precious thing that we have read n number of times we have come across. But if you give them time, at least to the people who are your inner circle, people whom you meet often, people whom you really care for, you want them for life, I think, share with them. Just caress, just be there, hug them. Giving cannot be material, right? Eighth thing that comes to my mind, and that is, don't just see, feel. We are sensible people. What I mean by this is, we are made out of those elements called as senses. We can see through eyes, we can smell, we can eat, we can taste, right? We can hear, and we can have that feel of touch. Five senses. And you say, you only see. People who have vision may not necessarily be having eyes. They might be blind, but they have vision too. A lot of physically challenged and mentally challenged have a feel factor. Maybe if you think this seriously, you definitely understand what I mean. And what I mean is, just feel. And the next thing that comes to my mind is the ninth thing. Don't just dream, just do it. People have a lot of dreams, daydreaming, night dreaming also, but they do not remember what they have dreamt about. It's very hard to recollect on the dreams part, but one thing is for sure. Abdul Kalam ji, you know, gets reminded every now and then. What a man. Says, dreaming small is a crime. I would say, whatever that your dream, whatever your dreams are, be it smaller or bigger, you need to plan for the dream, you need to live that dream, and you need to see that it gets fulfilled. Be it for yourself, be it for anybody who's very close to you, anybody for that matter. I think if we talk about dreams together, I think that's a wonderful living. And that's what the society needs. 10th thing, and that is, don't just hear, listen. We often say, I heard you. In fact, when I say this, what I mean is, I do not have an intent or the purpose to actually understand what I heard. When I say this, yes, I'm listening to you. That means I have all the intention and the purpose behind, not only to listen to you, but I want to know you, I want to feel you, I want to be with you. Maybe there's a sharing, caring, love, bonding, attachment, association, and maybe a heart and soul into it. So if I'm there with you, I would like to listen to you. There are many friends who do not talk much, but they are there to listen. Do not lose them. Wonderful association it is. And you are blessed that way. I have as my life partner. I think that what makes me to boast about and tell you at the same time, that care for them, be for them, The 11th thing that comes to my mind is don't just talk, act. Don't just talk. People would say it's he's a man of words, only words, no actions. So if you mean what you say, if you mean what you talk, might as well show it with your actions. Act. Many a time, people only may not be at the hindsight, they will tell you on face because nobody has time. Nobody will do that. But seriously, if you talk and if you do not show it in your action, you are not a person to be taken seriously at all. People say that living in a fool's paradise is what you are doing. Please do not do that. The last thing, the 12th one, don't just exist, live. What I mean is, I have a passion. I have an interest component. And that's what I'm doing. I'm not existing. At least I'm not trying to exist. With this recording and with this YouTube channel, what I'm trying to do is living beyond my death. I don't know, one day, for sure, nobody is going to live life till the eternity. There has to be a full stop somewhere. If I go, I really wish the purpose that I started this YouTube and maybe whatever the learnings, whatever the skill sets, whatever is my experience to narrate to the society is because I strongly believe that in my past, I had so many people who contributed in shaping up what I am today. So I existed. I existed with a lot of incompleteness. And today, I'm still incomplete without them. Many have left me. But there's this strong thing that you are living not for yourself, for your family, for your friends, for your relatives, for someone, maybe the students. One, you know, hello and talking to them makes a lot of meaningful moment and life out of it. I strongly believe that live, stop those grudges, stop those things, you know, which small things which you hold up, you know, keep it to your heart and keep it for life. Maybe forgiving is good, forgetting doesn't come so easily, but try and come over it because it is only going to eat the peace of mind of yours. So till whatever time that you live, at least be an example. People leave this world and when they are recollected, I think one good thing about you should be that he was a person of great sense, great meaning, smile, laughter, humor, something he shared. A 10 digit away, a person is highly accessible, reachable, you know, talkable for that matter, is a great sense of giving. So the purpose of life is what I strongly believe with this 12 pointers. If you also believe, simple, do it. Be happy. God bless. Thank you.